Where the medics managing the COVID patients in Mazakar Regional Referral Hospital want their risk allowances paid. The medics told the visiting parliamentary COVID-19 task force that they have not received their allowances since May 2020. They want the committee to push government to pay up. We have more.
Members of the Parliamentary Task Force Committee spent the entire day inspecting hospitals managing COVID-19 cases in Masakar City. Hospitals visited include Masakar Regional Referral Hospital and St. Joseph's Hospital, Chitovu. Health workers told the committee that they have not received their risk allowances since May 2020. They also lack sufficient protective gear. Evans Ndianabo, a nurse at Masakar Regional Referral Hospital, asked the Ministry of Health to act on extending help to health workers because many of them are contracting COVID-19.
We are exposed to this virus of COVID-19, even if we are not directly attached to CTU. If you may realize it, most of the health workers who are infected, they were not from CTU, meaning that even if you are not there, you cannot be in full PPE full time. Meaning that at least we request the government to pay us some risk allowance. The rate may not be the same as those ones who are in CTU, managing positive patients, but at least we also get something small.
Dr. Lydia Nawire, the national president for interns, reminded the government about the parliamentary resolution to increase their allowances as per the presidential directive.
Recently, as you recall, we won a strike, a sit-down strike, are demanding for the implementation of the parliamentary resolutions on increment of our allowances, which led to meeting the president, and he gave a directive that starting 1st of July this year, 2021, our allowances will get increased to half of the pay of the qualified seniors in the different fields. But up to now, we have not gotten a written directive from the office of the president, which makes it really hard to do follow-up. And so we have not gotten any feedback or any progress on the issue. And yet, our allowances, risk allowances, are not being catered for.
The hospital director, Dr. Nathan Onyachi, asked for a second oxygen plant to boost the existing one. He said with the current COVID crisis, they are unable to support lower health units in the region.
The second wave, all patients, 100%, that were admitted have been oxygen dependent. Unlike the first wave where you saw patients doing press-ups, this time it was very serious. Everybody who came in here was oxygen dependent. And on average, they consume one to three cylinders per day. Meaning that our oxygen plant could only support about 20 to 30 patients per day. And that's the reason we are picking oxygen from Kampala. Initially, it was every 2 days. Then we increase it to every day.
He also asked Parliament to remind the Permanent Secretary of the Health Ministry, Dr. Diana Atwine, about the pending 5 ICU beds they were promised during the first COVID phase.
I saw some received 8, others 7, but we received 5. So I've asked the PS that we would wish to have the 10 that was promised the hospital, because the ICU that we're preparing is a 10-bed ICU.
Dr. Abed Bwanika, the Chimanya Kabonero lawmaker, who is also a member of this committee, pledged to follow up on the delayed risk allowance payments.
We are going to follow it with the Minister of Health to ensure that the medical workers, the health workers, and all the people at the front line, not government, must make sure that they pay them that which is due to them. The money for risk allowance was budgeted.
He implored the government to recruit more medical workers to fill the gaps in various health units as growing infections among medical workers continue to strain the system. After inspecting the regional referral hospital, the committee visited St. Joseph's Hospital in Chitovu. They pledged to push the government to support non-profit hospitals.
Particularly with COVID, as you saw in Lacho, they got 4 ICU beds. Even Chitovu should be getting for the region a few ICU beds and extra human resource and extra facilitation, because as you've seen in Kampala, treatment of COVID is very expensive, yet the same treatment is offered in some of these facilities at a much cheaper cost.
This story was compiled by Tony Kaliango for the news in Masaka.